Hello. Welcome to the Interactive Lab for JAMS Enrollment Customizations. My name is Jonathan Uresco, and I'm a Senior Consulting Engineer here at JAMF. I'd like to give you a warm welcome to Virtual JNUC 2021. This lab will give you a firsthand look at how we can customize a personal end-user experience and give you the tools to set the groundwork for an ideal zero-touch deployment workflow. Feel free to head over to jamf.it/enrollmentlab2021 for the interactive portion of this presentation. I'll give you the link again in a little bit. Here's a quick look at our agenda for today's interactive lab. First, we're going to start off with the understanding why behind all of it. Why do we need or want any of this? Next, we'll learn about what zero-touch deployment actually is, because I know sometimes it can feel like a pie-in-the-sky buzzword being thrown around. It truly is achievable, it can be customized for your organization, and you'll look like even more of a rock star than you already are. We'll then walk through what enrollment customizations are and the capabilities. I'll show you how easy it is to set up in your very own environment, and then we'll wrap it up by seeing it in action from the end user's perspective. Sometimes as an admin, you'll see all the setup involved, but not the end result. I will be available in chat for questions every step of the way and during this process. Now let's get started. Before we dive into anything technical, let's talk about the why. Why custom enrollments? Why zero-touch deployment? Why care about the end-user experience? I know for some of you, the answers to these questions may be, because my boss told me to. Others may want to be that rock star at their organization. When it was me, I wanted to ensure the minimal amount of IT tickets. Getting the end users off on the right foot immediately after pressing the power button put the power into the fingers of the end users. It gives the confidence and tools needed to be successful, keeping the technology overhead or headache at a minimum. If it's your first time customizing an enrollment experience or your 50th, taking the weight and work off your hands and empowering the end user is extremely beneficial to all parties. How does it really help you as an admin, though? Well, it's found that time spent setting up the computer can actually be cut by 80% when we use a zero-touch workflow. This means putting more time back into your day to get all those projects you've been meaning to do done, knocking out that IT ticket queue, or better yet, giving you the time to tackle more complex or awesome workflows. Ever wanted to learn to code or automate? You just gained quite a bit of time. Long gone are the days that you have to manually touch and configure these devices. Properly guiding the end user experience at the beginning will reduce the overall quantity of IT help tickets. A streamlined experience for your end user where they can start up the laptop and get working right away with the logins they're familiar with and the apps and settings needed gets them off on that right foot. With the help of a pre-stage enrollment combined with enrollment customizations, you can eliminate the confusion as it's already done for them. Some studies have even found that this strong onboarding can improve employee retention rates by 82%. Their productivity also increases by 70% because of that ease of use and get them working right away. Currently, in talking about enrollment, we can either enroll devices with automated device enrollment, user-initiated enrollment, or an on-premises network scan. Previously, to get content on the device, after enrollment, imaging was an option for older devices and OSs. The technology that allows for imaging has gone by the wayside. And real talk, it took a long time to get that golden image. And it was frankly the least scalable option. If you happen to still be imaging or are worried about the transition to a scalable provisioning experience, there's a three-part JAMF blog on such a transition by someone I'm a big fan of. Yes, imaging is dead. Zero-touch deployment has arrived. Moving on to what zero-touch deployment actually is. I know it seems like a buzzword that has already been used at least 10 different times in this presentation, and be prepared because it's going to be used a lot more. But what is it exactly? To understand zero-touch deployment, we must also take a look at what deployment tools exist. Zero-touch utilizes enrolling Apple devices using Apple's automated device enrollment, which utilizes Apple's activation servers to, well, automatically enroll those devices over the air rather than a user navigating to a link through a browser and expecting them to click all the buttons. This is that true out-of-box, this device is mine experience. IT nor the end user have to manually touch the device to bring down the MDM profile or binary, since Jamf is doing it all for you. This means that if you choose, and I'd recommend when possible, you can ship the device directly to the end user after purchasing. Automated device enrollment is, well, automatically enrolling these devices, but once they're enrolled in Jamf Pro, deploying out all the applications, profiles, and policies that they need are also automated. It's a seamless process to get your devices ready and users onboarded. Now on to enrollment customizations. Enrollment customizations take automated enrollment pre-stages one step further in order to create a unique branded experience. To accomplish this in Jamf Pro, you're presented with an easy to set up walkthrough of steps that you'd like the end user to then walk through. Secure authentication, device assignment, and a branding guide are just a few of those highlights. We can even utilize Markdown for formatting, allowing you to create custom panels during the pre-stage, like displaying an end-user license agreement, other company policies, really anything to your heart's content. You can even add photos, embed YouTube videos, or just plain text if you like. You're able to choose different color codes with HTML color choices, and you can even add an image of your choice for consistent branding on each page that you present the end-user with. The options are truly endless. I know these workflows seem too good to be true at times, and it can seem daunting at first. Really? Just ship the device to an end user and your worries are gone? A customized experience means fewer IT tickets? Well, let's walk through these workflows and show you exactly how to do it so you can create it in your environment and see for yourself. As I mentioned earlier, enrollment customizations have many options. Developing such a workflow in Jamf Pro gives you the ability to seamlessly adjust the end user experience as you go and tweak for specific groups of end users if desired. Let's break it down into a few steps. Pre-stage panes give you the ability to choose in what order you'd like the end user to be presented. Here, you can choose to configure single sign-on or LDAP for authentication to later be linked with Jamf Connect, or just to assign the device to the end user. For the text options, this is where you can include YouTube videos and photos and customize that text you'd like the end user to see during the enrollment process. If you have EULAs or other text you'd like the end user to see, you can add that here as well. Once you have your panes or walkthrough configured, you can customize its look and feel. Moving into the branding and preview, you can use a PNG or GIF of the logo of your choice, whether that be your company's logo, your school's logo, or just something fun. You're able to choose color selections for the background, text, buttons, as well as previewing what you previously created for the pre-stage panes. The preview in Jamf Pro gives you a look at what you created for the deployment without having to enroll a test device to see that end user experience, and then test, wipe it, and then test again, and then test, and then wipe it again. It's a huge time saver being all in the user in the GUI. You're even able to preview the appearance for all types of Mac, iOS, and iPadOS. Finally, you'll add that enrollment customization to your selected pre-stage enrollment, whether that be one that has previously been created or a brand new one. Now, if you haven't already, let's navigate over to jamf.it/enrollmentlab2021. And feel free to either follow along or check it out at your own pace after the presentation when it's made available for you. Let's build it together. We're going to go ahead and navigate over to the global management settings inside of Jamf Pro, and you'll find enrollment customizations. If you want a shortcut, you can go to all settings and hit Command F and type enrollment customizations, and it will get you there just as fast. I know sometimes there's a lot of text on the page and it always seems like I could never find the one that I'm looking for. Once you click enrollment customizations, click on new, and it'll bring you to a general page that looks like this. This is where you will create your own enrollment customization. Add in a display name and a description of this enrollment customization. This is only for you, the IT admin. The end user will not see this. We'll call it 2021 device enrollment. If you end up having multiple customization options, you'll be glad you filled in some of this info that describes each one. This can either be a general name or a specific one based on who you'd like to deploy it out to. Once you have that done, we're going to click Add Pane in the bottom right. And when we do that, we'll get prompted for yet another display name. Like the previous, this is only visible to the admin and anyone who can view these enrollment customizations inside Jamf Pro. It's not actually visible to the end user. As mentioned, there are three different types of panes: text, single login, and LDAP. Looking at the text pane, you're able to choose a title for the pane, which is visible to the end user. So you want to make that something like, "Welcome to JNUC 2021. Overall, just describing what's occurring on the pane during the enrollment process. The body is where you can use Markdown to, say, embed that YouTube video or add photos or text. Let's just call it, "Welcome to JNUC 2021. Congrats on your device." We can add some button text for the previous button that they'll see, and then the next button that they'll see. Once we're good, we can click Add, and that will save this pane in the enrollment customization. Let's make a new one. We're going to name it first. This will be named the acceptable use policy. Because this is text, and I mentioned earlier, we can add a YouTube video or we can add a link. We can actually just take a link that we've made and guide the end user to it. We'll say, "Please follow the below link to review our acceptable use policy." And we'll add our acceptable use policy link here. Keep in mind, it is required to name the previous and next button text. It can either be something as simple as previous and next, or it can name it something different like back or onwards. Get creative with it and see what looks best. Some IT departments have their own marketing team. I envy them. You're also able to have the next button be part of this agreement use policy, like "I confirm" or "I agree." Those are some great options. Now that we have what it looks like, we can click Add, and we'll add another pane. This next pane is going to be authentication. You're able to pass this user information onto Jamf Connect as they sign in utilizing your sign-on of choice. Jamf Connect supports Okta, Azure AD, Google Cloud, OneLogin, Ping Federate, a whole bunch of them. If you do not have Jamf Connect implemented, that's fine, and you're using just single sign-on pane or LDAP, you would make sure that you pre-configure your single sign-on in the all settings to make sure it's all good to go when creating this pane for authentication. You'll designate the text for what you want the login to say and add the specific LDAP groups that you have already created and set up in your all settings. So we'll add our LDAP group, administrators. And once it's found, we'll select it and we'll click Done. And we'll click Add. Now, once they're logged in at the pre-stage, we want to show them a YouTube video. But first, we want to make sure that they're actually logged in before we show them the YouTube video, because the YouTube video may be proprietary. We don't want to show just anyone it. We can also have as many YouTube videos as we want. But for now, we want to make sure they authenticate first. And then once they authenticate and they're logged in, we can show them a video, say, of what self-service will look like when they get to their desktop. Once we give it a display name and title, we can use Markdown and embed a YouTube link. This is really a great way to give some general onboarding in how to right from the get-go. So we'll go over to YouTube. We'll copy our YouTube link. And we'll pop it into the text field. You can also customize this with animations. If you have Dropbox links, whole slew of things you can have in here. Make sure we name our buttons and we'll click add. And keep in mind, you can have as many of the panes as you wish, but we do want to minimize the amount of work it takes for the end user to get to the desktop. Now we'll click on branding and preview. And this is where I mentioned you'll be able to see or add your GIF or logo onto each pre-stage pane. You can just browse the file or drag and drop it as we've done here. On the left-hand side, you're able to customize the color scheme for the panes as well. You can customize the body color, text color, button color, any color you choose. Now, time to preview. You can see the background color with your branding and how it all ties together. You can click on Mac, iPhone, iPad to see how it looks as it changes with the size of the device as well. Even the preview of the YouTube video shows up here. Once we have our enrollment customization, we can make a new pre-stage to apply that enrollment customization to. You can find it under your device choice in pre-stage enrollments. Go ahead and click add or new, and we'll fill in all the information necessary. We want to make sure that we select the things we want the end user to either see or skip as part of the pre-stage, and any of the organization information that you want to display or present to the end user at time of enrollment. This dropdown is where the magic happens. Once you've specified all the parameters and settings you want your end users to walk through, we got to make sure that we specify that enrollment customization configuration that we just created. If you're not into spoilers and don't want the finale to be ruined for you, make sure you go through the interactive portion before watching the rest of this. I'll leave 3 seconds to pause and you can come back later to reference. Okay, but for those that can't wait to see and what they want to see what the end user experience looks like, see how beautiful it can be, well, the user boots up the Mac for the first time. They go ahead and select their location and Wi-Fi for or Ethernet for internet. This Mac is on Ethernet, so no Wi-Fi needed. The device click will already hit automated enrollment, immediately presented with our enrollment customization. The branded experience was only 3 clicks from booting up the machine. The user will walk through whatever you supplied during authentication, including their credentials, things that they already know. And after accepting an acceptable use policy, you can begin the onboarding process with videos like that self-service video. Once they're ready and they've viewed the self-service video, remote management will configure everything else. And voila, we're at the desktop. Devices assigned, devices managed and secured. And you, IT, did not need to touch this Mac. As I mentioned though, if reprovisioning a device that is an Apple School or Business Manager, this can be the same flow. Just make sure it's wiped prior to sending these to the end user. Again, if you missed that link earlier for the enrollment portion or for the interactive portion of this lab, here's the link, jamf.it/enrollmentlab2021. Thank you.